I think that is, it's just commitment phobia has this awful label,
yes,
doesn't it?
Yes,
actually, I think that's just,
yes,
kind of a natural thing that when we're discovering ourselves,
yes,
that's what,
I agree,
that's what
I agree,
we do. We don't want to be tied down.
Yes, I wanted to bring that up because I think it is an awful label, really. It makes people feel bad about themselves, and it's an easy one to point the finger at others, especially maybe women pointing at men, and we can talk about that a bit later. I'm sure loads of people will have questions about that. Like, am I dating a commitment phobe?
Yeah,
how do I know?
Yeah.
But I was thinking about it in terms of clarity and your story. I think there is a huge difference between people who are almost like maybe have a clinical tendency to be very frightened of being committed, mm-hmm, and feeling trapped and feeling tied down, which is a little bit of what you alluded to, versus people who are just in a different life stage who just want to kind of have fun, explore,
yeah,
play the field, meet lots of people, not ready. And again, something you've said in one of your writings, I think when it works is when you are both in the same stage, isn't it? The,
yeah,
same life stage. So I almost think it's a bit of an unhelpful label to be saying people are, oh, they're scared of commitment, because it's maybe like we could turn that into a positive.
Yeah.
They want to explore and meet as many people as possible.
And actually,
that's what sounds what happened,
yeah,
to you.
And I always said, you know, I want to meet, when I emerged from this commitment phobic stage and wanted to meet someone, I then decided I want to meet someone who's been through what I've been through and has played around and has been a little bit commitment phobic and now is ready like I am. Because I think unless you've gone through that, you've got to want a relationship, and I wanted to meet someone who wanted one, just like I had. Because then you know, at least, they're not going to be thinking, oh, the grass is always greener.
Yes.
They're not going to be missing the fact that they might not have had chance to live out their single years. But I think we've got to stop thinking of commitment phobia as being this bad thing. Oh my gosh, they can't commit. They're just playing around.
Yes.
But actually think of it as quite a natural phase. I mean, not for everyone, of course. Some people just know what they want. Some people really enjoy companionship all the time, but they're not good on their own. And that's fine. We're all different. But for a lot of people, it is scary getting into a relationship, and you do give things up. You know, let's not deny that. So I'm in a relationship now, and I'm really happy with it. But I have given things up from my single,
yes,
life.
But you
I
need
do
to
see
the
my
maturity,
friends less,
or to get to that point. Maybe not maturity. That sounds a bit. But it is something, everything about relationships for the human being is this balance between we want our freedom and our independence, but we also want security and comfort.
Yeah.
And almost like you can just look at that pull between those two.
Yeah.
And I think maybe when you're younger or in a different phase, the pull of independence and freedom and individuality is probably greater than the need for security.
Absolutely.
And comfort and safety. Really.
Yeah. And
that goes on throughout the relationship, as you're saying now, even when you're in a settled relationship, you still feel that, don't you?
You still feel those things that you give up, but I suppose the idea is hopefully, you know, you're going to meet someone who's, you actually want to spend time with them more than you did doing all the other things,
yes,
that you used to do. And that's the key as well. I think when I was in that, wow, life's so brilliant, I want to explore it, or like, you know, going through life like a kid in a sweet shop, all wide-eyed, then you do feel like a relationship is holding you back. But I think once you start to get into a rhythm of life, I think for me it was when my career settled down, when I just settled down, then that's when you start to think, okay, I don't mind giving up those things, because actually the person I'm with, I kind of prefer to spend time with them than doing all these new and experimental things that life has to offer.
Yeah. I have to ask you, oh, well, two things really. There's been some eHarmony research recently, and interestingly, 25% of their respondents self-identified as commitment phobes. So that's quite interesting. We could talk a bit more about that with my theory about whether you really have got a serious problem, which probably would need a therapist to help with, if it's something from your past that has really scarred you, and you actually, phobia means terror, it's fear, so that you might have an actual,
yeah,
terror of closeness, often goes with them feeling trapped and that you can't get out of it, versus these 25% who self-identified. I'm wondering how many of them are more like what you're describing, of kind of, you said playing the field, didn't you?
Yeah, discovering yourself.
Discovering yourself.
But interestingly, I found when I was researching this topic for one of my books, and I was interviewing lots of people, lifelong bachelors and things, I identified two types of commitment phobics. I hate that term, but let's go with it.
It's our working title for today. Yeah.
So the first was sort of the type that I was, which was just simply hasn't discovered themselves yet, it's wants to live life, right. Wants to experiment a little bit.
Life stage.
Life stage, maybe, yeah. Yes. And the second ones were the ones who have been hurt and are shutting yes. themselves off. And what they said to me, you know, I was really trying to get to the nitty gritty, what is it you're actually scared of? And they said, it's not the relationship per se, it's not the being with people, because very often they love the dating
yes.
side.
Yes,
it's
yes.
the pain of the extrication. Of yes. It's the fact that they think, say if they have been through a painful divorce,
yep.
that they might have to go through that again. So they're not actually scared of a relationship, they're scared of the extraction, of coming out of that relationship.
Yes,
and
yes.
that tends to be people that have gone through, you know, I'm funnily enough, I'm now dating someone who is in that bracket. And I remember him saying, you know, it's, you give so much to something. It's that, you know, coming out of that, that's the painful bit.
Yes, and it's feeling the stakes are raised really high,
absolutely.
Isn't it?
Absolutely, so that tends to be older
yes.
people, I think.
Yes.
And like, but it can manifest itself in the same way, because I think people in those circumstances will still then go through the crazy dating phase, the maybe an uncommittal, okay, let's explore my freedom again phase. But they're coming, I think the cause of their so-called commitment phobia would be, it's very different.